WAER alum Sean McDonough. You're listening to SU Basketball on WAER Syracuse.
Inside the Carrier Dome, it's Syracuse basketball here on WAER. I'm Connor Green, joined alongside my broadcast partner, Michael Tricarico. Syracuse enters this one at 12-9 on the season, attempting to take down the number 6 team in the country, Florida State. And Michael, the Seminoles are one of the tallest teams in the country. For reference, the Milwaukee Bucks are the tallest NBA team at a height of 6'7.5". FSU enters with an average height of 6'7", so not only one of the biggest teams in college basketball, but one of the biggest teams in basketball in general. And Florida State, one of the best offensive teams in the nation at 84 points per game, led by Dwayne Bacon. He's the guy that makes it go for the Seminoles. Both teams about to take the floor. The starting five for Syracuse: Andrew White, John Gillen, Tyus Battle, Tyler Lydon, and Torian Thompson. And on the Florida State side, it's Jonathan Isaac, Dwayne Bacon, Terrence Mann, Xavier Ratan Mays, and Michael Ojo. The two teams take the floor. Syracuse wearing all white uniforms with orange numbering and lettering, with Florida State wearing black uniforms with gold and red numbering and lettering. After the tip, it's Torian Thompson against the 7'1" Michael Ojo. Ball goes up and FSU wins it. They'll take over first possession going right to left. Syracuse, of course, in the 2-3 zone. Ball controlled on the near side wing by Mann. Looks to Ojo down low, but instead kicks it back out to Xavier Ratan Mays. He drives inside and gets an easy bucket on Andrew White, and FSU picks up the first 2 points of the game. John Gillen gets the ball on the inbound, running the point for Syracuse going left to right. Guarded one-on-one by Ratan Mays. Pass to the baseline to Tyus Battle comes loose. Ball rolls out of bounds, and Florida State takes over going right to left.
It's one of those unforced errors, but it was a good play. Tyus Battle went back door. Florida State aggressive defense would have been open if they could have connected. Could have been an easy layup.
Jonathan Isaac on the near side, now controlled by the sophomore Dwayne Bacon. Back to the far side to Mann. He passes down low to Isaac. And a travel called against Terrence Mann in the paint. So Syracuse forces their first turnover of the contest and goes left to right. Just under a minute gone here in the first half of play between Syracuse and Florida State. The Seminoles on top 2-0. John Gillen dribbling the ball on the offensive end. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Gillen one-on-one with Ratan Mays. Passes to the near side to Tyler Lydon. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Right-handed dribble on the right elbow. He kicks it to Torian Thompson. 3 seconds on the shot clock. He launches a long three. It's no good. And rebounded by Dwayne Bacon. Bacon to Isaac on the near side. And now Florida State just recontrols possession slowly on the offensive end. Ratan Mays shoots a three, hits front iron, no good, comes loose to half court, and rebounded by Mays himself. Pass to the baseline to Jonathan Isaac. He backs down his defender with a fresh shot clock for Florida State and called for a travel on the far side. The second travel violation of the game for the Seminoles, and Syracuse takes over.
It was a good job by Syracuse to rotate. You gave up the offensive rebound, but Florida State didn't get even a shot off of that second chance opportunity.
Florida State on top 2-0 with 18:20 to go in the first half of play. John Gillen swing past the near side. Three for Andrew White, and he swishes it. First bucket of the game for Syracuse, and they go on top by 1-3-2. Xavier Ratan Mays looking down low to Michael Ojo. Nothing doing, and the Seminoles just kick it out. Jonathan Isaac on the far side baseline, and he's pushed by Andrew White. A foul called against the Syracuse grad transfer. And Florida State will inbound it.
The only problem with that is White didn't cut off the sideline. He allowed a path for the offensive player to get around, and then you just have to foul at that point. If White got to the sideline, then it could have been a true trap, because that sideline's your best friend as a third defender.
Ratan Mays has it off the inbound, splits a double team, and bounce passes it near side to Dwayne Bacon. He lofts a baseline pass to Jonathan Isaac, who jumps up and corrals it. 15 on the shot clock. Isaac double-teamed on the baseline and clears it back out to Bacon. He takes a 15-footer, hits front iron, rolls off the rim, and rebounded by Torian Thompson. Syracuse on top 3-2 with John Gillen going left to right in transition. Now to Andrew White on the right side elbow. Comes off a screen from Tyler Lydon. Steps back and picks up his dribble. 15 on the shot clock. Lydon now controls. Guarded one-on-one by Isaac. to Gillen, who comes off a screen from Lydon. Baseline pass to Thompson, and once again, a little bit too low, it rolls out of bounds. Second turnover on the game for John Gillen, and the Seminoles go right to left.
And Jim Boeheim's looking at Torian, clapping his hands to say, come on, be ready for that, because it was not a bad pass from Gillen as far as the positioning goes. Thompson just needs to be in a little bit better spot to receive it.
Torian Thompson, of course, off a great game against Wake Forest, where he scored 18 points on 7 of 10 shooting. FSU on the offensive end, the sophomore Dwayne Bacon kicks it down low to Michael Ojo. Ball slapped loose by Torian Thompson, and he's called for a foul. First foul on the game against Syracuse. And, of course, the first personal against Thompson. Phil Kofer checks into the game for the first time, and he'll inbound. Fresh shot clock for the Seminoles. Ball passed to the top of the key to Ritson Mays. Back near side for a three for Bacon. Hits front iron, no good, and rebounded by John Gillen. The six-foot point guard, Gillen, goes left to right and passes to Andrew White. He gets the ball and dribbles it into the paint. A foul called against Terrence Mann. That's his first personal, first team foul against Florida State. And Syracuse will inbound the ball underneath the basket. John Gillen lofts it all the way into the backcourt, where it's picked up by Tyus Battle. Fresh shot clock for Syracuse with 16:50 to go in the first half. The Orange on top, 3-2. Tyus Battle drives inside, lofts a pass to Torian Thompson, and he lays it in easily. Syracuse on top by 3, 5-2, with 16:35 to go in the first half. Terrence Mann on the near side wing, working on Syracuse's 2-3 zone. Now to Xavier Ritson Mays, who bounce passes it near side to Dwayne Bacon. 15 on the shot clock. Mays left-handed dribble back to Bacon, who drives baseline on Torian Thompson, kicks it back out to Mays. 7 seconds on the shot clock. He drives inside, goes up with a layup, and is fouled underneath the basket by Torian Thompson. That's Thompson's now second foul and third team foul for Syracuse.
Yeah, Thompson easily just his hands, you got to keep him, if he keeps them straight up, not only does he get the block, but it's not a foul here. He brought his hands almost horizontally down, and it was a clear foul. I mean, an easy call for the official to make.
Xavier Ritson Mays to the charity stripe, shooting 59% on the season, and his first shot hits back iron and shoots out no good.
You know, something Syracuse is doing well, though, defensively over the last really two or three games is consistently trapping more in the corner, and then that next guard has to find where the next pass is, because that gets set up for a turnover.
Second shot, no good, rebounded by Tyler Lydon. Lydon gets a pass, shoots a three, and air balls it nowhere close. It bounces out of bounds, and Florida State will take over. Checking into the game for the first time as well is Tyler Roberson in place of Torian Thompson, who has a little bit of early foul trouble. On the offensive end, it's Ritson Mays to the near side for Forrest. Trent Forrest checking into the game. He passes to Michael Ojo. Cleared back out to Ritson Mays, who dribbles inside, kicks it out, and the ball rolls out of bounds on the pass. Syracuse forces another turnover and will go left to right after the break. 15:52 to go in the first half. SU on top 5-2 against Florida State. Timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. More SU and FSU after this on WAER.
It's time for more first half Orange basketball on WAER.
Here inside the Carrier Dome, Connor Green joined alongside my broadcast partner, Michael Tricarico. Syracuse leading Florida State with 15:52 to go in the first half of play. And Michael, so far Syracuse's defense coming out sharp, three forced turnovers in just the first 4 minutes.
Yeah, and Connor, that's been the key for Syracuse this year. If the defense plays well, Syracuse is going to be in these matchups. And look, Florida State struggled against Georgia Tech early on. Syracuse has to take advantage. There's been times when the Syracuse defense has held teams scoreless for long stretches, but the Syracuse offense really hasn't done much with it. If SU can extend a lead, and you're not going to put Florida State away early, but at least gain confidence, the Orange's best wins, Pittsburgh and Florida State, came because Syracuse got out to an early lead and didn't have to play from behind, whereas against North Carolina, Virginia Tech, Notre Dame, essentially every road game, Syracuse started out slow, got behind, had to play catch-up, and just didn't have enough firepower to come back.
In their last game, Florida State came out very slowly against Georgia Tech, trailing 41-15 at the half. So in this one, coming out and playing a little sloppily early on again, already three turnovers through the first 4 minutes of the game. And again, Dwayne Bacon is the man to watch on the offensive end, named to the Oscar Robertson Trophy watch list. He has double-figure scoring in 30 consecutive games, but thus far, Syracuse, through 4 minutes, doing a pretty good job defending him.
Look, sometimes Syracuse allows one or two players to get hot. It's been a problem. The one player you don't want to get hot is Dwayne Bacon. Make everybody else on Florida State beat you.
Bacon thus far 0-for-2 from the fields. Syracuse controls on the inbound following the turnover on FSU's last possession. John Gillen has it at the point guard position, going left to right, working one-on-one with Trent Forrest. Far side pass, and a three from White is no good. Comes loose, rebounded by Tyler Roberson. Near side pass to Tyus Battle, and he backs it back out. Guarded one-on-one by Xavier Ritson-Mays. Tyus Battle comes off a screen from Tyler Lydon and passes it to Lydon. Far side, kicks it to Andrew White. He drives in, right-handed layup is off the back iron, no good, and rebounded by Michael Ojo.
Might have been easier to try and bank that in off glass. You don't have to be so perfect with it.
Terrence Mann on the offensive end, now to Ritson Mays. Baseline pass down low to Kofor, it's no good. Rebounded by Michael Ojo, but he travels in the paint. The fourth turnover on the game for FSU, and Syracuse takes over. Three travels already on the game for FSU, who now brings a little bit of full court pressure against the Orange.
Something Syracuse did well in that last possession. Got a good shot right in the paint. Ball movement, that's the key to the Syracuse offense.
John Gillen crosses the timeline and into the front court. Andrew White, top of the key now to Tyus Battle. Crossover dribble straight away with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Drives inside with the right hand, goes up with a layup and gets it to go down. Great move from Tyus Battle, and Syracuse on top by 5, 7-2.
Love the aggressiveness from the Syracuse players attacking the rim, being aggressive there as well.
Now to Trent Forrest, 14:30 to go in the first half of play. Syracuse up 5-5. Ritson Mays working on a double team, clears it back out to midcourt. Forrest has the ball, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Dumped down low and a missed dunk by Michael Ojo. Syracuse going left to right. Tyus Battle to Andrew White. He gets an easy layup to go down. And a timeout called by Florida State. Syracuse on top 9-2 with 14:14 to go in the first half of play. SU coming out on fire, and FSU will talk things over. We'll step aside as well for SU and FSU after this on WAER. Back here inside the Carrier Dome, Connor Green joined alongside Michael Tricarico. Florida State with the ball in possession. Going up with a layup is Terrence Mann, and it's no good, but it rolls out of bounds off of Tyler Roberson. So Florida State will recontrol possession underneath the basket. Jonathan Isaac, the freshman, will inbound the ball, scoring 13 points per game for FSU. Has not taken a shot yet, though, for the Seminoles. Clears a half court to Trent Forrest with a fresh shot clock for the Seminoles. Far side to Terrence Mann. He dribbles into the paint, passes it to the far side to Isaac. His shot is nowhere close. Rebounded by Mann, and it's loose and tipped back in on the play by Jarquez Smith. His first bucket of the game, and the lead now narrowed to 5 points. Syracuse on top, 9-4. John Gillen on the offensive end. 17 seconds on the shot clock. Comes off a screen from Tyler Roberson. Now dumps it down low to Roberson. Backing down Michael Ojo. Now goes up with a layup, and it's blocked away by Jonathan Isaac.
You know, I like the patience from Roberson. He went up with that. Now, Roberson's not a guard, but that's got to be Tyler Lydon coming in and calling for the ball because Lydon's man's the one that got the block. Little dump off could be an easy dunk next time.
13:22 to go here in the first half of play. John Gillen on the inbound passes it to Andrew White, and he's fouled on the floor by Terrence Mann. Second team foul for Florida State.
Look, North Carolina was a team that got up and pressured hard man-to-man, and Syracuse played tentative. They didn't attack the basket. Today, Florida State's getting up, pressuring, and Syracuse is attacking and forcing the fouls.
Dwayne Bacon checking into the game. Does not have a point thus far. 0-for-2 from the field. John Gillen on the inbound. Pump fakes a three. Passes it to the paint to Andrew White. Ball picked loose from him and picked up by John Gillen. Baseline pass to Roberson. He goes up with a layup and is fouled. He'll go to the line for two shots.
Tyler Roberson did it really well against North Carolina, and he's done it well throughout his career. He positions himself really well for when his man helps. It's an easy pass from the guard. That's a trait, because sometimes your man will help, but you won't position yourself in the correct spot, so it makes it a tough pass for your guard. Roberson finds the opening when his man helps, that he's able to get an easier pass and at least have a better attempt at the basket.
Roberson's first shot from the line is no good, so Syracuse remains up by 5 points. Roberson shooting on the season 53% from the charity stripe. Second shot from the Syracuse senior is off back iron as well, so he misses both of those as Florida State goes right to left. C.J. Walker in the game for the first time, passes near side to Dwayne Bacon. He throws it down low and it's taken away by Andrew White, but his pass goes awry as well. And so the Seminoles will go right to left. Florida State, a team that rotates in and out a lot of players, sometimes going 10 plus deep on their bench, where Syracuse really has only gone with around 7 men on the floor on the year. FSU with possession in the offensive ends. Walker has the ball, passes near side to Smith. To the foul stripe to Dwayne Bacon, he kicks it back out. Layup is no good, blocked away. Now loose, picked up by Isaac, and he's fouled underneath the basket by Tyler Roberson. His layup is no good, so Isaac will go to the line for 2 shots. Jonathan Isaac named to the Karl Malone watch list as a freshman, which goes to the best power forward in the country on the season. He's been really great as a freshman, 13 points and 8 boards. His first shot is good. Isaac, largely regarded as one of the best recruits in Florida State history, was the number 12 recruit in the country last year by ESPN's Top 100. Isaac's second shot is off back iron, no good. Ball loose, picked up by Jarquez Smith. Now to Isaac, he takes a foul line jumper, that's no good. Smith rebounds it once again. His pass is deflected away by Tyler Lydon, but Smith picks it up once again. Great hustle from the FSU big man. But the ball now comes loose once again, and Gillen takes over, going left to right, and he turns it over. Going the other way, it's Jonathan Isaac, and he slams it home in transition, uncontested. Florida State narrows the deficit to 2 points, trailing 9-7 with 12:10 to go in the first half. John Gillen crosses the timeline, working on full court pressure, and now a pass by Andrew White comes loose. Going right to left, Wayne Bacon with an easy dunk, and the game is tied at 9. A 7-0 run for FSU. Couple of costly turnovers there from Syracuse. The game now even with 11:45 to go in the first half. 15 on the shot clock in the offensive end. Tyler Lydon to the far side to Tyus Battle. On the left side, extended elbow. Chest pass to the near side to John Gillen. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Gillen picks up his dribble. Bounce pass to the paint. Jumper by White. Rattles around and finally goes in. Syracuse goes back up by 2 with 11:25 to go in the first half.
Another great back cut by White and a good shooter's roll.
Dwayne Bacon pump fake, now steps inside the arc. Shoots a jumper and swishes it. Dwayne Bacon picks up his 4th point on the game, and it's all tied at 11 with 11:05 to go in the first half. John Gillen on offense, dribbling it slowly with his right hand. Now chest pass far side to Andrew White. Left-handed dribble to the baseline, step back jumper is smushed.
He's feeling it.
Andrew White once again connects for Syracuse. He's got 9 points already. The Orange up by 2. Dwayne Bacon on the offensive end, guarded by John Gillen. Swung around the key to the far side to Trent Forrest. Back to Bacon, guarded by Roberson. He splits a double team and now is trapped in the corner by Roberson. Baseline pass to Forrest. He goes up with a layup and it's swatted away by Tyler Lydon. Picked up by Bacon. He takes a bunny hook and it's no good. Rebounded by Syracuse. The Orange going left to right. Pass and a shot from White is a little bit short. Picked up by Jarquez Smith. In transition, the pass comes to Dwayne Bacon. Cross-court pass to Jarquez Smith, and Tyus Battle attempts to pick it away and is whistled for a foul. 15th foul for Syracuse as the Orange leads it 13-11 with 10:10 to go in the first half. Timeout on the floor, will take one as well for Syracuse and FSU on the other side right here on WAER.
It's Andrew White III, 4-3.
on WAER.
White's been on fire inside the Carrier Dome against the number six team in the country. He has 9 points on 4 of 7 shooting as Syracuse leads it 13-11 with 10-10 to go in the first half of play. And right now, Michael, it's been all Andrew White for the Orange.
Yeah, I mean, White is a player who, when he's playing confident, you can tell. And on his last basket, it was a little step back. He took 2 dribbles, step back, create the space, and he took the shot. And that's been his shot this year, but he just had a different look to him. And he had already scored 7 points total before that. He knocks down that jump shot. And White has been the really main offensive player breaking up Florida State's run, and that's what you got to do. Basketball is a game of runs. The key is to end the other team's run as quickly as possible. Andrew White was able to do that for Syracuse. Look, the Orange was up by 7. Florida State tied the game. Syracuse got a basket. You got to outscore this Florida State team because they're not going to do as poorly on offense as they've been doing. Syracuse has taken advantage of some mistakes, but the Orange has made some mistakes as well. Florida State got 4 straight points on Syracuse turnovers.
And right now, Syracuse playing really well defensively against one of the better offensive teams in the country. The Seminoles right now shooting 5 of 7 from the field. FSU has the ball underneath the basket off the inbounds and will control on the offensive end. 10-10 to go here in the first half. Syracuse on top, 13-11. The pass from Phil Cofer is thrown to midcourt, where FSU now controls. Cofer has the ball, now to the far side. It's taken by C.J. Walker. Dumped to the foul stripe to Dwayne Bacon. He pump fakes a shot, passes the ball, and it's knocked out of bounds by Andrew White. Syracuse continuing with their active hands on the defensive side of the ball. Already have forced 6 turnovers in the first 10 minutes. C.J. Walker has it on the inbound with 15 seconds on the shot clock. Comes off a screen from Chris Kumaji, and now back out to Trent Forrest. Down low to Kumaji, the 7'4" player for this FSU team. Picked back out to Trent Forrest. His shot is no good, and the ball comes loose. Picked up by Tyus Battle. Going left to right, Euro step layup is swatted away by Chris Kumaji. He blocks it out of bounds, and Syracuse will take it off the inbounds.
Look, it's a big block, and it prevents a basket, but if you're Syracuse, you're just going to say, okay, it's still our ball.
Kumaji blocks the ball at 7'4". He's the tallest player in Florida State history. Tyus Battle has it on the inbound with 20 on the shot clock. Working one-on-one with Dwayne Bacon, left-handed dribble into the paint, and a foul called on the floor against the FSU sophomore.
Oh, look, that's why you got to do it. I mean, you start driving. Florida State, they got the arm bar right above it. I mean, you could see that foul before it was called. Syracuse has just got to be more aggressive to draw those fouls out a little more.
And that's the first personal foul for Dwayne Bacon, the 4th team foul for Florida State. The ball inbound to Frank Howard, who checks into the game for the first time. And the ball taken away by C.J. Walker, but a foul called against him as it happens. And the ball was taken away by C.J. Walker, and then when Frank Howard goes to grab it back away, a foul was called on him. So instead, the foul goes against Franklin Howard, and the Seminoles will go right to left.
Look, it was a foul on Frank Howard, but I think he was hit twice before he lost the ball, and those should have been called. But again, Howard wasn't aggressive. You got to be aggressive and go into that contact.
The Seminoles rotating players in and out. Xavier Ritson-Mays back into the game, and he controls at the top of the key. Pass down low to Kumaji, who clears it back out to Ritson-Mays. 15 on the shot clock at the top of the key. It's passed to Phil Savoy Jr. He kicks it near side, and a 3 is good. Brian Angolo Rodas connects on a 3. And FSU takes a 1-point lead, 14-13, with 8:45 to go in the first half. Tyus Battle on the offensive end, coming off a screen from Tyler Lott, and right-handed dribble to the right side elbow. Kicks it back out to Franklin Howard with 15 on the shot clock. He comes off a screen and kicks it at Tyler Lott, and working one-on-one with Jonathan Isaac. Pass out to Tyler Roberson. He drives in the paint, picks up his dribble. 5 on the shot clock. Tyus Battle has it. Fadeaway jumper is off the front rim. No good. Ball loose and corralled by Jonathan Isaac. The Seminoles going right to left in transition. P.J. Savoy goes up with a layup, and it's swatted away by Tyler Lydon. His 5th block on the game already. Syracuse on the offensive end. 3 from White. Hits front iron. Comes loose. Picked up by the Orange. Now to Battle of 3. Rims out, no good. Ball loose, picked up by Frank Howard. No good on the layup once again. Three misses for the Orange, and the Seminoles take over. Xavier Ratson-Mays on the offensive end. Now to P.J. Savoy Jr. His three is way far, nowhere close, and taken by the Orange. Up the front court, layup by Tyler Roberson is good. Roberson gets loose on the offensive end, and Syracuse goes back up by one. 7:30 to go in the first half. Syracuse with a one-point lead over the number six team in the country. Another steal by Syracuse. Andrew White left to right and is fouled as he goes up with a layup on the play by Ratson Mays. So White will go to the line for two shots after the break. Syracuse up by 1 point, 15-14 with 7:23 to go in the first half. That's the score inside the dome, but for a look around the nation, we'll send it back inside the WAER studios with today's host, Paul Mancano.
You're listening to Syracuse Men's Basketball on WAER. Now back to today's voice, Connor Green.
Here inside the Carrier Dome on 80s Day in Syracuse, New York, the Orange on top against the number six team in the country, Florida State, 15-14 with 7:23 to go in the first half of play. And right now, Michael, Syracuse has been phenomenal on the defensive side of the ball. They've forced seven turnovers and have blocked six shots, five of those credited to Tyler Lott.
Syracuse leads the nation, leads the ACC rather, in steals per game with more than eight per game. But Syracuse is only forcing less than 14 turnovers per game, which is seventh in the ACC and middle of the pack in the nation. So Syracuse's 2-3 zone, while it's forcing steals, Jim Boeheim isn't wrong when he's saying, look, we don't force a lot of turnover. You know, we couldn't beat the local high school in turnovers for us. Syracuse is doing it more with steals. The Orange maybe has to turn Florida State over a few more times, but the Orange also has to take advantage more of those live ball turnovers and get fast break points.
Before the timeout, Andrew White was fouled as he drove the ball into the paint, so his first shot was good. SU now up by 2 points. White at the line. His second shot is good as well. Andrew White has now connected on back-to-back free throws, and he's been great from the charity stripe of late. Was 10 for 10 at the line against Wake Forest. Angola Rodas controls on the near side wing, and he feeds it back to the top of the key to C.J. Walker. 15 on the shot clock. Walker working on the 2-3 zone. Swings it to Cofer on the near side, who dumps it down low, and the ball comes loose. Foul called on the play, though, by Tyler Lydon.
And Jim Boeheim's telling the official what I thought I saw and what Tyler Lydon's saying, too. Look, I was being held off. There was an extended arm for the offensive player. Lydon tried to work around it, and the only contact made was really the Florida State player, in this case Smith, reaching his arm out and hitting Lydon.
Jarquez Smith goes to the line as FSU is in the bonus. He'll shoot a 1-1. His first shot is swished, and the score Syracuse 17, FSU 15. Smith, a phenomenal defensive player, the senior, is the 16th player in school history to block 100 or more career shots. He has 113 in his career, but zero in this game. Second shot is swished as well by Smith, and Syracuse now with just a one-point lead with 7 minutes to go in the first half. Frank Howard on offense passes baseline to Roberson. His jumper is good. Tyler Roberson connects on the baseline, and Syracuse goes back up by three. Phil Cofer in the near side, elbow extended. Baseline pass down low to Angola Rodas, but it's no good, and rebounded by Andrew White, who just took the ball away from Rodas. Now Frank Howard in transition, goes up with the right hand, and it's no good. Ball pushed back out to the top of the key, where it's taken by the Orange, and Franklin Howard now gets the ball and takes a couple of steps a little bit too quickly before he put the ball down. A travel called, and FSU will take over.
Now that was credit that call to the Florida State bench. It was close. Now credit, it was close. It was a very late call from the official. I don't care if it's late, if it's the right call. Not sure if that was the right call, though.
Jim Boeheim disgruntled with that one, yelling at the officials on the floor as FSU takes the ball back on offense. Near side three from N'Golo. Rodas is an air ball as it bounces out of bounds. And Syracuse will take it left to right. The shot nowhere close, and Syracuse continues to play well defensively.
And again, you have to take advantage of these. That's a one and done for Florida State. The Seminoles already in this ball game are controlling the offensive boards. Florida State with 9 offensive rebounds, but those times where they don't get a second chance opportunity, you get a defensive stop, you gotta score and go on a run of your own.
FSU right now shooting 26% on 6 of 23 shooting. John Gillen has the ball on the offensive end, checking in for Franklin Howard following the travel. Tyus Battle has it on the near side. Elbow drives in with the left hand, goes up with his right, and gets the layup to go down. Tyus Battle drives inside and gives Syracuse a 5-point lead. Ritson Mays now on offense, guarded by Battle. Ball swung around the key to Trent Forrest, down low to Dwayne Bacon. He powers his way inside and gets 2 points over Tyler Lydon. In transition left to right is John Gillen with 5:35 to go. He passes to Lydon, who drills a three. Tyler Lydon straight away, and Syracuse jumps up 24-18. That's Lydon's first made shot on the game. And again, the Orange up by 6. Crowd erupted on the Lydon three. Syracuse with a lead here over the number 6 team in the country. Trent Forrest has it, clears it out to Dwayne Bacon. His three is no good, but it's flushed home on the rebound by Jarquez Smith, showcasing his athleticism in the paint, and the lead narrowed to 4 points. 4:55 to go in the first half of play. Syracuse up by 4. John Gillen shoots a straightaway three. It rims out, no good. Rebounded by Jonathan Isaac. In transition is Ritson Mays, and he controls it straightaway. Bounce pass to Trent Forrest. He gives it to Bacon on the baseline, who goes up with a layup. It rattles around and no good. Rebounded by Lydon. Battle controls. Goes up with an alley-oop, and Tyler Roberson slams it down with both hands. And the crowd erupts here inside the dome. Ritson Mays on the offensive end straight away, and he's fouled on the floor by Tyus Battle, and Jim Boeheim once again not happy at all with that call. Second personal foul from Tyus Battle, and the 8th team foul for Syracuse. So Ritson Mays will go to the line for a 1-1.
Boy, I mean, geez, some of these touch fouls are not going both ways.
His free throw is no good, and Ritson Mays now 0-for-3 from the line. Syracuse has the ball, working left to right. John Gillen at the point. He drives inside, passes to Roberson. His layup goes down, plus the foul. Tyler Roberson with the and one, and Syracuse up by 8.
I told you, there's not one player better on the team right now for Syracuse that gets himself in a better position to receive a pass than Tyler Roberson. It was a great pass from Gillen, but Roberson put himself in a fantastic position for when his man help made it an easy pass.
Roberson checked in early in the game for Torian Thompson and is now 4-of-5 from the field with 8 points. His free throw, though, is no good. Ball rolls around on the floor, and a foul called against Florida State as Tyler Lydon attempted to rebound it. And so Lydon will go to the line for a 1-1 as well against Syracuse in the bonus, as FSU has 17 fouls. Tyus Battle checks out of the game in favor of Frank Howard, and gets a standing ovation from the crowd. 4:01 to go in the first half of play. Syracuse up by 8 points, and Tyler Lydon to the line for a 1-1. Lydon on the season, an 82% free throw shooter. His first shot is nothing but net, and Syracuse up by 9 points against FSU. On the contest, Syracuse is 3-of-6 from the charity stripe, compared to 3-of-7 for Florida State. Lydon takes a few dribbles, And his second shot connects as well. The Orange up by 10 points with 4:01 to go in the first half. And now the crowd rises to its feet inside the zone. Terrence Mann has the ball on the offensive end to Angola Rodas. A three now from Walker is no good, and rebounded by Tyler Lydon. The Orange going left to right. Frank Howard has it. Straight away, pass to the near side to Gillen. Drives inside, a floater is nowhere close, an air ball. Ball comes loose on the floor. One player goes to the ground. And a foul is called on the play against FSU. Rather, the ball rolls out of bounds. No foul call despite a player going to the floor. So Syracuse will have it after the timeout. 3:40 to go in the first half of play. Syracuse up by 10. You're listening to it on WAER.
You're listening to Syracuse Basketball. Now back to more first half action.
Back here inside the Carrier Dome, Syracuse on a 15-4 run, up 30-20 with 3:40 to go in the first half of play. I'm Connor Green, joined alongside my broadcast partner, Michael Tricarico. And right now, Michael, Syracuse really feeling it on the defensive side of the ball. FSU just shooting 29%, and they've turned the ball over 7 times already in the first half.
Syracuse has pressured Florida State. They've trapped the Seminoles in the corner, forced those turnovers, as you mentioned. And what Syracuse has done over the last 6 minutes is rebound the ball. Florida State at one point had 6 or 7 more shots than Syracuse. Florida State had 9 offensive rebounds in the first 8 minutes of this ball game. The Seminoles have gotten just 1 offensive rebound in the last 6 minutes.
Syracuse on the offensive end of the ball. Tyler Roberson has only scored 6 points per game on the season, but in this one has been red hot in the first half. 4 of 5 shooting with 8 points. Coming off the bench, he's been a real presence down low.
Yeah, he certainly has, and Roberson is a player who just puts himself in a good position for his teammates. You know, Syracuse needs to drive more against pressure man-to-man defenses like Florida State is playing right now, but the Seminoles are good at helping and blocking shots. So what do? If your man helps, you have to go in a position that whoever's driving is going to see you. Roberson's done a fantastic job of that. He's gotten 6 points just on positioning himself in the correct spot.
Earlier in the year, FSU played a 6-game stretch all against ranked opponents and went 5-1. But right now in the Carrier Dome, trailing Syracuse by 10 points with 3:40 to go in the first half. After the timeout, John Gillen will inbound the ball for Syracuse. 18 seconds set on the shot clock. Gillen inbounds the ball. Top of the key to Tyler Lydon. He shoots a 3 and gets it to go down. The second 3 from Tyler Lydon, and Syracuse up by 13. Dwayne Bacon on offense at the foul stripe. Back to Walker. He goes inside, shoots a 15-footer, and connects. C.J. Walker gets it to go, and the lead is narrowed to 11 points. Ball comes loose at midcourt as Frank Howard brought it up the floor. And a foul called against Frank Howard as the ball was loose on the floor. That's Howard's second, and Florida State will go right to left.
It'll be a great tackle of a linebacker coming up to the line to chop down a running back that just broke through the offensive line, and in this case, you can't do that in basketball.
And Syracuse could have maybe used that when they played FSU in football earlier in the year, but here, of course, you can't do that on the basketball court. So Florida State in the bonus will go to the line for a 1-1. Shooting is Brian Angola Rodas. He shoots 67% on the season. His first shot is good. And the deficit now 10 points. Syracuse on top, 33-23. Angola Rodas is 6'6", the junior out of Columbia. At the line, down by 10 points here against the Orange. His second shot is off back iron, and Tyler Roberson skies in the air for the rebound. Franklin Howard has the ball, working on a double team at midcourt. Now to John Gillen, who gets across the timeline. 3 minutes to go in the first half of play. Syracuse up by 10. Tyler Roberson has the ball, attempts to pass it at Tyler Lydon, but the ball is thrown awry, and FSU will go right to left off the SU turnover.
Well, Florida State's playing a 1-2-2 press, and it's not necessarily to trap right away in the backcourt. They wait, and that's what the 1-2-2 is. You wait till the team gets over half court, and that's where you trap, because the midcourt line is a third defender.
And now the Seminoles pressure has forced 9 turnovers on the game from the Orange. Alley-oop pass down low is slammed home by Chris Kumaji. The 7'4" center slams it down, and the lead now 8 points for Syracuse. Franklin Howard playing back and forth with John Gillen. And now Andrew White has it on the far side baseline. Pass it to Gillen, who drills a three. John Gillen nails a three-pointer for Syracuse, his first points on the game, and the Orange back up by 11 points. Terrence Mann on the offensive end, straight away outside the perimeter. Now to Angola Rodas, jumps inside and clears it back out to C.J. Walker. Back to the near side to Mann, jumped inside to Kumaji. Right-handed hook shot is no good, and rebounded by Andrew White as a foul is called on the floor against Brian Angola Rodas. So Syracuse in the bonus will shoot a 1-1.
Syracuse almost ripped that ball away from themselves. Tyler Lydon and Andrew White both had it. They ripped it away, then White got it. It was a scrum on the ground. Syracuse was really fighting itself for a majority of that defensive rebound.
White finally comes up with it and is fouled, so he'll shoot the 1-1 as the Orange on the game. With 36 points, White has 11 of them. His first shot is good, and Syracuse goes up by 12.
Syracuse is making this run, not the entire thing, but a lot of this run, with who but both freshmen on the bench, two freshmen that have played a big role for Syracuse in ACC play. Right now, Bay, I'm going with some more experience.
Back into the 1-1 from White is good. He's now 4-4 from the line and has 13 points for Syracuse. 2 minutes to go in the first half. The Orange up 38-25 over number 6, Florida State. C.J. Walker has it on the offensive end. Now to Terrence Mann. Right-handed dribble to the top of the key. Double-teamed by Gillen and Frank Gabbard. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Ball taken away by Andrew White. Syracuse going left to right. Gillen has it. Bounce pass to the paint. Franklin Howard shoots a 15-footer and connects.
It's an easy game if you make it that way. Find the open man, pull up jump shot, textbook offense.
Frank Howard's first made basket, and the crowd rises to their feet inside the zone. Steered by John Gillen, going left to right, goes up with a layup and is fouled under the basket. The layup is no good, but Gillen will go to the line for 2 points as the Orange defense forces another turnover, their 9th forced turnover on the contest. John Gillen on the game is 1-for-3 from the field with 3 points. Has not shot a free throw, but now goes to the line for 2. The 6-foot guard's first shot is good, and Syracuse goes up by 16. Now all 7 players for Syracuse that have checked in have scored on the contest.
They just look so confident right now. All the guys in the court look confident.
They do, as Gillen drains his second free throw to go up 42-25 with 1:15 to go in the first half. C.J. Walker has it straight away, guarded by Frank Howard. Drives inside, but a foul called on the floor.
Good foul. He was able to get to the basket and finish, so.
That goes on Franklin Howard. That's his third foul of the game. That's the 10th team foul for Syracuse. And so FSU in the double bonus, they'll shoot 2. C.J. Walker is the man that goes to the line. He shoots 74% on the season. The first shot from Walker is no good off the back iron. And so Syracuse remains up by 17 points. Florida State on the game now, 4-of-10 from the charity stripe. Walker, a freshman, 6'1", out of Indianapolis, Indiana, one of 3 finalists for Indiana's Mr. Basketball last year. His second shot connects, and now Florida State down by 16 points, 42-26, with now 1 minute to go in the first half of play. One of the best halves of basketball we've seen from Syracuse this season. John Gillen on the near side, wing outside the 3-point arc. 15 on the shot clock. Gillen with the crossover dribble. Goes inside. Hook shot is no good. Ball comes loose on the rebound and finally corralled by FSU, but the ball is tossed away. Tyus Battle goes inside. Near side pass to the corner to Gillen. He clears it to the top of the key to Lydon, who shoots a three. It bounces around and comes out no good. Rebounded by FSU. But John Gillen off the rebound steals it away. Passes down low to Robinson, who lays it in and one. The Orange tenacious on defense, forcing another turnover, and again it leads to a basket by Roberson. Syracuse now has forced 11 turnovers in the first half. Roberson going to the line to complete the three-point play, but his free throw is no good. Syracuse, though, on top, 44-26, with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Once again, the crowd rises to its feet, with the Orange playing fantastic against the number six team in the country. C.J. Walker working straight away, shoots a three, blocked away, and it's taken by Tyler Lydon. 3 seconds on the game clock in the first half. The ball still loose, and finally time runs out. But not before Syracuse takes an 18-point first-half lead and goes on top, 44-26 inside the dome. And Michael, that was just a fantastic half of basketball from Syracuse, both on the offensive end and especially on the defensive end, forcing a multitude of mistakes by the Seminoles.
And that's the Syracuse defense and just Syracuse team as a whole that you're so used to seeing year in and year out. Defense turning into offense on the other end. 10 fast break points for Syracuse off of those turnovers. And look, yes, Syracuse has forced 11 Florida State turnovers. Syracuse has turned it over 10 times themselves. If the Orange didn't make that many mistakes, especially in transition a couple of times, Syracuse might be up by at least 20 points in this game.
Syracuse at the half once again on top, 44-26 over Florida State. That's a score in the first half of play. We'll come back with the second half in just a bit, but for now we'll send it back inside the WAER studios to get you started with Orange at the half and to today's host, Paul Van Conner.